We are going to be talking about brand building via sports. And for that, I would like to invite Mr. Ruhul Amin, our editorial lead, Exchange for Media Group. He's going to be moderating this session. And our panelists for this session are Anita Nair, Group CEO, India and South Asia, Havas Media Group. Anupam Boke, VP Marketing CMO, FMCG Brands, RP Sanjeev Goenka Group, to please join us on stage, along with Sai Narayan, Associate Director and Head Marketing, PolicyBazaar.com and Paisa Bazaar.
Thank you, Tejal. I think after you, I'm the second most seen person on stage. So yes. Thank you.
Thank you so much, and over to you now, Ruhul.
Thank you. So I'm lucky, privileged to be talking to the brand experts here in front of me. And we'll be talking about how sports as a platform has become an unparalleled channel for brand building. Can you hear me? Okay. Before we head into this discussion, there's an AV that we need to play. Then we would kind of start. Yes.
Sport has the power to change the world.
A new world record for Usain Bolt.
It has the power to unite people.
It will be some can-can on the Champs-Élysées tonight.
Sport can create hope.
Bobby finishes off in style. India lift the World Cup after 28 years.
First silver medal.
India. 10 wickets in an innings.
Magnificently judged catch.
How many of these historic moments do you remember?
Six sixes in an over.
Sport leaves you dazzled.
Hamilton takes the checkered flag.
Sometimes on cloud nine, and sometimes in tears.
Brazil are being humiliated by Germany, and their supporters simply cannot believe what they have seen.
Nothing can prepare you for the drama of sport. Sport separates as much as it binds. New rivalries and friendships are formed in seconds. The father might be a fan of the precision of a Federer backhand, but the son would adore the never-say-die spirit of Nadal. But one thing is for sure, they'd both be sitting there, glued to their screens, united by their love for sport. The spectacle of sport can bring time to a halt. Nations come to a standstill. Roads become empty. Stadiums and living rooms get packed.
Millions watching around the world.
Sport conjures up gods and legends from mere humans.
I am the greatest.
Years of sweat and blood unraveled in a matter of seconds. Young or old, poor or rich, sport doesn't differentiate. The joy sport gives, the passion it evokes, the goosebumps it delivers. No other sphere of life can.
My life between 22 yards for 24 years. It's hard to believe that wonderful journey is coming to an end.
Thank you very much for just making it so special.
Because sport is life. And life is a sport.
I'll start with you, Anita, ma'am. If we look at this AV, it sums up the deep emotional connect, you know, all sorts of emotion, excitement, you get really emotional about things. All these could be evoked only through a sporting platform, and this probably explains why it has become such a big platform for brand building. In your view, what are the factors that make this platform so effective for brand building?
See, I think as far as sports goes, and there's again nothing new that I'm going to talk about. The fact is that cricket rules the roost, and you know there are brands here who've been absolutely you know patronizing cricket for a very long time, and we see a lot of sports emerging now. The new emerging sports, which has wrestling, which has got kabaddi, which has got you know soccer, and of course I mean with Mary Kom doing the sixth on the medal, you know, boxing and Olympics and all, you know, Hima Das and everybody getting the medals in. I think as Indians, you know, there is there's something that touches our hearts here. I think we are a little more passionate than many more other countries, and we are far more patriotic, you know. So it's that feeling here of really winning and, you know, getting up there, which really connects sports beautifully to the hearts of the audiences, you know. And from times immemorial, we've seen how cricket has panned out, you know, and how it's a religion, you know. And I mean, not to talk about India Pak, where it is war and religion and God knows what all, you know, all put exactly. put into one, and everybody making good use of it, whether it is the brands and the audiences, and you know, even the sporting authorities doing that. So I think the reach of cricket, the fact that we are, you know, we connect very well with cricket, the fact that we have pride in winning are some of the factors which make sporting events very, very close to our hearts. And there is so much more in emerging sports where so much more needs to be done. You know, the classic case is Kabaddi. You know, today I think after cricket, it's ISL and Kabaddi, which are the two main sports which are doing extremely well. You know, so I think there is a lot that also needs to be done in the other areas. But at an overall level, I think we're very soft at our hearts, and I think that's the connect with the sport and the winning of the
sport. It has the elements to make us emotional. Okay, Anupam ji, I mean, I also want to come. You have chosen Virat Kohli over Bollywood superstars, and this kind of underlines the importance of sports. But how do you sum up the importance of this platform?
No, actually, it all depends on what is the requirement for the brand. And when we were designing 2YUM communication, the platform was guilt-free snacking. So we actually wanted to, as a purpose, liberate the Indian youth of unhealthy snacking, which the whole country is used to. So we needed somebody who espouses those values, who is very health conscious. And he can become the face of the brand because it will only promote the brand in a very powerful and a very focused way. It was always also on the backdrop of him very publicly announcing his departure from unhealthy snacking. So I think that was also the platform which helped us. We were also a startup brand. 2YUM was just launched in April of 2017. So we are just about a year and a half old. So it was also about establishing our credibility. And we needed somebody who could help us do that. Otherwise, a company coming from the East, which is very large, by the way, but ourselves going and pitching a brand to the trade, to the consumers, especially on a platform of health, where there are so many failures in the past in the healthy snacking range. And I can list down so many examples. So I think the odds were huge against us, but we had, as a purpose, decided to go ahead and pursue this route of liberating people from unhealthy snacking. So we needed a credibility driver, which Virat brought. We needed to engage with the youth, who are far more health conscious these days, as is everybody else. So actually, he epitomizes all of it. And that's why the values of what we are trying to create versus the values that Virat himself espouses, there was a perfect fit. To be honest, we just didn't start with you know, cricket and Virat. We actually started with who is the celebrity who will help us solve this marketing challenge. And there were certain youth icons in the Bollywood industry as well. So they were also on the list. But if you look at the visibility that cricket provides, it's about 305 days of cricket that happens in a year, which is like massive. And when you watch cricket, you watch it one day, you watch it for 8 hours, you watch a T20 for like 4 hours, and it is full on and high profile engagement. So I think it all worked very well. That's the reason why we chose him.
Sai, if I talk about Policy Bazaar, we know very well how you have used this platform. At the same time, you have not only helped the brand, you have helped the category, you know. So how do you see this platform, you know, from the way it helps you leverage, you know, your brand?
So for us, it's you know, it's first I'd like to say, when I look at sports as a platform, obviously cricket comes to the mind immediately, and not just as a marketeer, but even when I was a student, we used to watch cricket passionately, and you know, we've seen brands being built around cricket. The best piece of communication, so every all marketers used to put out the best pieces of communication on cricket, used to use cricket as a platform to launch the new communication, or be it the Vodafone Zuzus or Fevicol or all iconic campaigns have launched. So the clear thinking is that it's a cricket-loving nation, and the sport is watched extremely passionately, as Anita shared. And for us especially, it is the platform where the entire male audience aggregate for insurance as a product. So for us, it's an extremely important platform, because sports is where, exceptional IPL, where both male and female audience aggregate, which is also good for us. But if you look at, so the entire male audience aggregate for us in that one platform, which is sports, be it cricket or non-cricket. So for us, it becomes extremely more important to be present on sport, on sports, on cricket. So so that, you know, we can reach out to the real total audience. Also, the other important factor, as I see, is that the entire content viewing landscape has seen a radical change over the past 5-6 years. So television is still there, it's still the largest reach medium, but it's also the kind of the rise of OTT platforms have the catch-up content has increased a lot. So for as a marketeer, then when I look at in order to reach out to the audience, if I have to look at all the genres available for me, be it GEC, be it Hindi movies, there is a slight proliferation of audience happening. But cricket or sports is the only platform which exists where there is an appointment viewing happening, where my audience, I know that my audience is going to reach, because a catch-up content does not serve a great purpose for the audience.
I have a follow-up question on it, actually, from the same. Yeah. But before that, I'll just come for the brand story. There's a story, for example, Swiggy's story. If you could, like, we'd love to hear that story a bit, how Swiggy was built using the sporting platform, especially IPL. If you could share a few words on that.
Yeah, so I think interestingly, and Swiggy, we all know the case as to the fastest delivery platform that they have. And, you know, sports as an event, and as Sai said, A, live, and B, the fact, I think they are far more open to integrating, far more open to giving you a platform where you can do so much more, where the brand benefits actually come out very, very beautifully. So we, on IPL for Swiggy, we did the speedometer, because it was the fastest delivery thing, you know, and it kind of gained ground very, very quickly, because you're talking about Swiggy as being, you know, a platform which delivers very fast, and you're talking about the fastest delivery in the matches as well. So that was one very, very relatable attribute, which had synergies with the game as well as the benefit that the brand was bringing to the audiences. And the second thing was, I think during the non-live sections, interestingly, we could actually demonstrate, you know, where during a discussion in the non-live section during IPL, they actually ordered, you know, rasagullas, for example, from Calcutta.
You could have like the minimal order, something.
Yes,
like that.
Yes. So that was what it was attributing to, that you can order. I mean, there's no minimum cost to an order. So during the studio discussion, they actually ordered mishti and rasagullas there, and the Swiggy guy came in and actually delivered. You know that. So I think the brand proposition of various benefits that it is going to bring to the consumers is something that Swiggy did beautifully there. I mean, we are very, very happy to be associated with IPL and with Swiggy, and being able to, you know, bring this to forefront. And interestingly, today, as you are quoting, I think there are lots of brands who are looking at, you know, the way Swiggy actually made use of what was available.
It became a unicorn because of the sport.
Well, I wouldn't say Swiggy gets into unicorn only because of IPL.
Only because it plays a huge role in that, right?
Yeah, and there is, I think every element has played a huge role. And I think the offering itself from the brand and the way they are going about capturing the market, I mean, does lead them to, you know, the unicorn club,
right,
for
right,
sure.
Right. Anubha, what would you say the experience of your brand's story with Too Yum and sporting platform, how has it panned out for you?
No, I think it has worked out brilliantly. As I said, we needed a credibility builder for a new brand. So Virat's presence helped us achieve that. And I think the way the brand's proposition was articulated on paper, executing that through Virat and through cricket became easier. I think there were some key criteria which we had to necessarily keep in mind when doing communication also. That, you know, we are not using him just as a clutter breaker celebrity, but also to try and marry the values, bring his life space into communication. So it's always in the gym, is in a cricketing field, etc. Attributes like, okay, you are eating so much, yet you are so fit. So actually that helps build the brand's reason to believe of being healthy, and you can indulge without any guilt. So I think those values were able to be brought out very, very well. Just coming back to, you know, relationship with cricket and how we, I think on sports, some of the properties are very well established. There are fours, there are sixes, there are fastest deliveries, there's man of the match, etc. So you know really the properties and what they stand for. And if your brand has something similar, you can very easily create, co-create, and do a very strong brand integration. Whether it is fastest delivery or on 2M, we said, you know, ek khatam dusra shuru. And that's why we took the fall of wickets property, because you could binge to your heart's content through the match without feeling guilty because it's healthy. Yeah. So I think there are established properties which helps you
so to many points plan. To integrate upon, yeah. Yes. Tell me, traditionally insurance is a category looked at during that tax saving period, and you have moved it beyond that. You know, you've cut that orthodox approach to insurance. What is the role that sports played in building that perception about insurance?
Yeah, so I think this one point, I think it's a beautiful marriage of, you know, getting Virat to open a packet of chips is a fantastic thing. I wanted to compliment on that. But also, you know, there's one point before that. If you think of the innovation that Swiggy did and you guys did, this innovation can be done on other medium, other genres as well. But the kind of reach and visibility and the kind of clear integration sports give, it just takes it to a different level. That's where the consumers interact more. So that's the power of sports. So having said that, on your question of insurance, overall our category, advertising mainly on JFM.
But did sports actually help you change that perception? You had that captive audience, you had that, you know, the buyers were there, the young people were there. Did it actually help you impact that perception?
Yeah, I'll give you a very, very clear example. So IPL usually happens in the month of April, May. And for the longest time, we never used to be on IPL. Because those are the months where, you know, it's impossible to spend in those period, because the sales are down, the traffic is down. You really can't, the consumer is not even the thinking mindset. Like, to be honest, no one wakes up in the morning thinking of, you know, buying insurance as a product. No one is thinking. So it's a very difficult category, especially after Jan, Feb, March, where the maximum sales happen, when the consumer has just done his filing, tax filing, everything. So April, May are the leanest month for us. So when we thought of, you know, buying IPL, it was an extremely difficult decision, because if you look at a lot of insurance categories are not there on IPL. But if you look at our strategy, we are present throughout all 12 months. But when we did that, what we saw was we had the highest traffic. Because we couldn't easily measure the same month, the same day we can measure. So the moment we put our new piece of communication with Akshay Kumar, we signed up the brand ambassador and we put it on IPL, we got the highest traffic in a month which is supposed to be the worst month for us in terms of traffic, in terms of revenue, in terms of everything. So clearly it's like, you know, building a new category, building a category and getting the consumer thinking about insurance in months where he's not even thinking.
Perfect. So if we look at 2019, in advertising lingo, it is like double dhamaka. You have an IPL followed by a World Cup. How are you looking at leveraging this kind of combination? It's a cocktail of, like, you know, building brands in an instant. How do you see this? Are you already strategizing on it? I mean, how is it like for you?
Yeah, I think the strategy has happened much earlier. So it's a great year, frankly, you know, with so much of, for the lack of another word, overload of cricket. But, you know, IPL, for example, it's a question of the objectives of the businesses that, or the brands that you're talking about, and it's also a question of timing. You know, so for World Cup coming absolutely after IPL, I think the brand strategies, like I said, vary from category to category, and IPL brings a very different kind of a audience and an environment to the table, and World Cup brings also a very different kind of an audience. In fact, to my mind, you know, just to answer Sai's question, there is 40% female viewership now on IPL. So don't only look at cricket as a sports where you're aggregating only males. Huh? And interestingly for you, because, you know, coming from an FMCG area, you know, you can actually leverage that very, very beautifully, because both IPL and World Cup have close to 40 to 45% female viewership. And the female viewership is also in tier 2, tier 3 towns, by the way. Yep. You know, so it is very interesting if you look at these stats. And actually, I mean, it doesn't come every year, right? IPL and World Cup together. So our recommendations to brand is to actually encash on both. Because the environment that IPL brings to the table is more of entertainment, as well as, you know, fast playing cricket and various other, you know, the regional, the teams which are not really India, Park or whatever. It's a combination of various countries. Whereas if you look at World Cup from the attributes of it, it is really all to do with, you know, Team India, Team Australia, Team England or something like that. So I think reach platforms, both of them are phenomenal. You know, you look at, you know, the kind of reach that IPL does. I think over the 2 years, IPL has almost doubled its reach. And World Cup also gives you a decent reach, though it doesn't give you the reach of IPL for sure. It's a little short, I think about 20-30% less than IPL. But I think the strategies to take on both specifically, you know, in a year when both are there, because IPL will continue every year.
Right.
Yeah, and World Cup doesn't come
right.
every year.
Right.
So I think the strategies there are really to encash on both.
Right. Anupam, the fact with World Cup is that it unites the non-believers of cricket. Even they would, because there's national pride involved in it, which is not in IPL. IPL is more of a festive, loud, Indian cultural mix of entertainment, everything else. So these two different natured, slightly different nuanced properties, how are you looking at having them, you know, work for your yep. brand?
No, I think from a media point of view, both the properties are very powerful. The difference between IPL and ICC World Cup is, by the way, the thing is, even for the ICC World Cup, more than 80% of the audience is from the subcontinent. So I think that is a great thing. So you can still leverage that from a media point of view. What IPL allows additionally is basically on-ground activation and getting a stronger engagement with your brand. And that's why between the two, if you see IPL, we still feel being an Indian brand is more relevant for us. But World Cup also is equally true, where you can actually have more emotion and, you know, national emotion associated with your team. But both are equally large properties. They are very expensive, both the properties. So I think for brands, may have to make a choice whether you want to go with one or two. But if you could do both and you have the resources, I think it's a fantastic opportunity in one yes. particular year.
So, Sai, what kind of opportunities are you looking at, you know, at this kind of a combination?
I think it's going to be a very difficult decision if it has to be one or it has to be both, because both are going to be very extremely expensive properties, extremely expensive and
effective also at the same time.
Sorry,
but very effective also.
Obviously very effective, but we have 12 months and limited monies, so it has to be a very thought through decision. Like for example, I was telling, I've been telling Star that if IPL was in JFM, then you would find all the insurance companies advertising at that point of time. But unfortunately, that's not the case. It has to be a combination of both, as I see right now. But it's because, you know, unlike other advertisers, we advertise 12 months. So last time when I checked, we were 250 days on air last 2016-17. 2017-18, the number is going to be more. So for us, the way we view television advertising is very performance driven. Like, you know, when we put a communication out there, we get the traffic and that translates into customers and acquisition. So we need to sustain our media monies for 12 months across the two brands. So it's real difficult decision, but I can't pick one, but I think as we
both
get closer to
yes,
the
yes.
tournament, then we'll take a call.
Perfect. I'll take, I have two more questions. I am a little over time, but I'll just have to ask these two important questions. One is, apart from cricket, there is this rise of leagues. You have PKL, you have ISL, you have wrestling leagues. So the one sporting nation has changed into a multi-sporting nation itself. And again, a very great piece for, you know, marketeers when they look at sporting properties. How important are the rest of the leagues, apart from IPL and ICC, the World Cup, how important have the other leagues become for brands? Because they have this, they cut through linguistic barriers also sometimes. Even, you know, how IPL polarizes, you know, a father and a son. You know, that's a beautiful, like, positive polarization. How are you looking at the rise of these leagues, which are beyond cricket? I'll start with you, ma'am. Sorry. Ladies first, I'll go with this order. I'm following this order. Yes.
Gender biases.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm not...
Okay, so I think there is a lot of opportunity in the non-cricket part of it, and we've seen that, as I mentioned earlier, in both kabaddi, wrestling, as well as soccer. I mean, you guys have a soccer team as well. You know, what is interesting about these sports is it also has, and we're looking at some data, it also has a lot of following in the tier 2, tier 3 towns. You know, both wrestling, kabaddi, and even soccer, because, you know, they are, the street plays there or the akhada yeah. plays there, you know. So you, and in, again, interestingly, because as you mentioned, linguistic barriers, so there aren't any of those. There, we find again that there is a large chunk of female viewership. So if for a brand, if you are actually wanting to reach out tier 2, tier 3 towns, where you also, and specifically for FMCGs, where you also have, you know, look at sports as a platform, you can just close your eyes and, you know, go on to a pro kabaddi league or a soccer league or whatever, because it's got mixed audiences. Both there. So I think the it's important for these sports to actually emerge, and hats off to all the brands and the players who are actually sponsoring these leagues. You know, I mean, if you, I think 2017 or 2016, the Hero Soccer League, when they opened up in Guwahati, I mean, it's a classic case of Amazon using, you know, the opening ceremony as the entry point where they announced their great festive sale of, you know, the early October that happens, which clearly shows that it is not only, you know, large brands who are using cricket, who are not looking at other opportunities, but brands like Amazon, where they're talking about large reach, not, and it's gender neutral, because you're looking at males and females both who do online shopping. And for them to actually get into an opening ceremony of a soccer event was amazing. So I think there is a lot that you gain from here, and also they are far more efficient. You know, we all know cricket is exorbitantly, expensive, but it's efficient.
Saturated, you know, also sometimes.
Saturated, but then they deliver, you know. Cricket, you can close your eyes and say it delivers, you know, it brings in those efficiencies. But yes, the entry or the cost of entry is very, very high. And if brands can afford that, great. But I think there is a lot of opportunities in the upcoming sports
with
for brands.
Leagues have opened and as
absolutely,
effective.
Absolutely, absolutely.
I think it just makes sporting options available to more brands than just the large brands. Cricket is, of course, very large. And, you know, what we are also seeing in sports is it has a very high affinity with youth. It also has a very high affinity with NCCS AB. Soap operas and movies, etc., start to have a stronger affinity downstream to SCCC and also. Actually, if you are a slightly premium brand, these are fantastic properties. And again, different sports, typically today even kabaddi delivers half the reach as what cricket delivers. Wrestling also delivers a quarter reach of what cricket delivers. So there are, depending on what is your reach requirement, what is your budget, what does your brand stand for, where are your audiences where you need to engage them, all those options are available. And I think this is only going to grow. The rise of cricket that we've seen and all the leagues actually bring in a different aura to the whole sport rather than just sport by itself. So cricket is high because we are a champion team. Elsewhere, it becomes more of a national team. But I think all these leagues, etc., will increase the stature and level of the game, the quality of the game, the quality of the players itself. Money is coming into these, so actually there are opportunities for them to earn and develop even further. So it's going to become very large, very, very large. And vis-a-vis sports versus GEC, if you were to take that comparison, there's the other option available to marketeers. I think the affinity and the engagement is much, much higher in sports. So more options for many brands, and we'll only see the activity increase.
Yes. I think quickly one word, which is I think live sports might end up saving television as a medium. Because 5-7 years down the line, I see the audience is moving towards newer, unless other genres really reinvent themselves. To be honest, I spend a lot of money on TV, but I fear every day because the audience is moving, and you can check with the audience here. So people are moving towards. So if you look at America, I don't know the exact number, but a huge amount of audience has already moved to Amazon, and Amazon is making great inroads in India. I am worried about other non-sports content on TV already, and as a marketer. But at the same time, it's a great challenging period. So that's why the rise of live sports becomes extremely important.
Yes.
To be honest, we have not been investing very heavily on non-cricket, but we keep doing very efficient buys. I think brands like us should come together to support live sports. Yes. But and also non-cricket sports should be slightly rightly priced also. At times it is not rightly priced, but that's different. But I think live sports will save TV.
Right. I think what live sports has done, if correct me if I'm wrong, the appointment viewing which we used to speak about, it has kind of given a strong argument against it, because without appointment viewing, you just go and wherever, whichever screen you have, you watch the live match and you don't want to miss it, you know. I think it has posed a serious challenge to that concept that we only go for appointment viewing. So my last question to you is, what is the future of sports marketing, given the kind of experiences it creates? For example, all of us remember when Dhoni hit that six, when Amir Suhail had a tiff with Venkat Prasad, you know. I mean, those memories, I think, are indelible when it comes to sports platforms. Keeping this in mind, what do you think is the future of sports marketing in India, according to you, if you have to just sum it up?
I mean, it goes without saying, you know, I mean, whatever is happening today in this year or previous years actually mentions a lot about the future of sports marketing. You know, while cricket will always stay mainstay, I mean, India is a country where, probably the only country where cricket is mainstay, for the simple reason, like I said, you know, we are very passionate about the game, and there are icons there whom we worship, right from, I think, Gavaskar and Kapil Dev to Sachin Tendulkar, now to Virat Kohli and Dhoni. So they are icons who are worshipped in the country, you know. So you will not be able to move away from that, unless, of course, it becomes, you know, absolutely unreachable, or it is only the reach is only for some brands who have actually the wherewithal to pay, you know, that kind of monies. But with the advent of newer sports, and as you said, the live part of it, where you want to see it there and then, rather than waiting for, you know, watching the episode of you know, a soap or a serial at a much later day, because you have the OTT platforms which are driving it. So it is there and then, the viewing. And also, I think people are becoming, as a country, we are all becoming very, very conscious of the fact that it is not only cricket. You know, the heroes are not only in cricket. I mean, for the first time this year, I think the Women's World Cup, which was happening, you saw a lot of chatter on social media on the women's cricket, while it did not, you know, it did not get its due. Yeah, but with Mary Kom winning the medals, you know, there was so much of
sense of national pride.
So I think it is in the interest of not only the sportsmen, and also the brands who should come together to actually build this sports. Look at hockey. I mean, it's supposed to be a national.
Yes, I mean, national, biggest example.
I mean, yeah. You know, and today with the World Cup happening there, I think it's fantastic the way, you know, so many countries are coming in and you know, somewhere, you know, in the interiors of India, not only in a metro. So I think there is a huge scope, a huge potential. And I think the brands who will be in a position to catch up with this, barring cricket, if they're able to catch in really, really fast, that's when, it should really get results for them in years to come.
Sure.
No, absolutely. I think there are more heroes emerging in every sport. I mean, seeing Hima Das, the way she ran, just gave you goosebumps. Or actually looking at Neeraj Chopra throwing the javelin and getting a gold medal, and he's only 18. And, you know, he pours his heart out. And I think these are iconic moments in sports which makes you feel more engaged, you know. We still get goosebumps when you see Kapil Dev lifting the 1983 World Cup, or Dhoni hitting the last sixer to win the 2011 World Cup. So I think these are fantastic opportunities. What the sports marketing channels, etc., are also doing is they have made the game very interactive. Right? You just don't watch a soap opera or a movie. There is a lot of engagement, texting happening, and I think the Star changed the game entirely last year, where there was so much of engagement beyond just watching the game. So I think it just allows you to engage to a completely different level. The other thing that Anita was saying is the game ends in whatever 2 hours, 3 hours, versus a TV serial which kind of goes on and on. You never know where it will end and where it will start the next time.
Without context,
that's quite boring. So I think high level of engagement, high level of anticipation, also emotional alignment, supporting the team, supporting the players. I think this engagement will only going to grow, and sports marketing and sports stage is likely to become very, very big going forward.
So your last words about the future of sports marketing, how important will it be?
Yeah, I think they really shared the real insight. But I just want to share just one point, which is I'll talk about non-cricket sports. Who will really drive the popularity of non-cricket sports is the audience. If you look at the amount of social media chatter that happens around the non-cricket sports, obviously, cricket will still rule the roost, but there's a huge amount of chatter that happens. So there are two kinds of audience then which exist. One is people who really follow these sports, and there will be other audience who will want to join the conversation because these new sports are emerging. So the conversation that are happening about the sports, people are generally making, so they will pull the people who want to join the conversation. So if you look at today, everyone wants to join the conversation, because there's a lot of chatter that happens. The real fans will also pull more audience, and therefore the overall sports is a property would increase.
Perfect, yeah. Perfect. And sorry, we're taking over time, but we have to play this last AV, and then it's over. Yes. Thank you once again for your time. Lovely talking to you. Yeah, thanks. Yes.